West Virginia University has fired several lethal shots across the bow, getting every opponent's attention so far. It's the Big East Women's Championship presented by Aeropostal, and for Connecticut players, this potential moment of enshrinement and enthronement has become an annual pilgrimage. And this man, the architect of five national championships for UConn, but a lethal opponent awaits tonight.
And I want to say this when we get in the game, because you know when we get in the game, I'm liable to say anything to you, okay? Very proud of you. At least you showed a lot of heart. Showed a lot of guts, showed a lot of heart. You brought it together, come down here and turn, all right? No matter what happens in this game. But I'll tell you what, just like I said, since we're here, we might as well just go ahead.
Welcome everyone to the Hartford Civic Center. It's Championship Week, presented by 7-Up, where the unimaginable becomes reality. It's the Big East Women's Championship, presented by Aeropostale. West Virginia at 15-15. They knocked off the number 5 seed, then the number 4 seed, then the number 1 seed. Tonight, one more step against the number 2 seed, UConn. Hello, everybody. I'm Mark Jones, along with Hall of Famer Nancy Lieberman. Thanks for coming aboard. This has been the biggest story in women's college basketball so far. West Virginia, the first number 12 seed, Nancy, to make it this far. Where do they go from here?
Well, who knew that West Virginia would do what they did, but they have one important factor. They got one of the best 2-3 zones in college basketball. They're holding opponents to 28% in this tournament. They scrap and they rebound. They're going to have to do it against a great offensive team in Connecticut.
They've got a heck of a losing streak going against UConn, but one player poised and ready to snap that 16-game losing streak, Shakia Cole.
Oh, my gosh. Has she lifted her game since Meg Bolger went out with her torn ACL? She had 18-9 against Rutgers. She's an energy player, an undersized post who has assumed leadership. And Barbara Turner is well on her way to being the most outstanding player again in this tournament. She was a year ago. She's averaging 16 in the tournament, and she's knocking down shots about 71%.
Let's take a look at the starting lineups for the respective teams. Montgomery playing great basketball in the last 2 weeks of the season. Thomas, Strother, Crockett, and Turner. Thomas back in the starting lineup for the third consecutive game. For West Virginia, Powell, the point guard. Davis-White, Owens, Cole, and Olayinka Sanni in the middle. She had 6 points along with 6 rebounds and several key plays last night in the victory against number 1 seed Rutgers. Geno Auriemma has taken UConn to 5 national championships, coaching his 700th career game last night in that victory. And Auriemma getting his team's attention very easily because of the upsets that preceded his team's opponent tonight. Mike Carey, meanwhile, the 5th season on the sidelines for West Virginia in his 18th season overall. Mike Carey admittedly told his players in the locker room, you heard it, folks, just a few moments ago, hey, we're here. Why not? Why not us? Earlier this season, UConn defeated West Virginia 58-50 in a game in which UConn sprinted out in front in the early going by a score of 8-0, and then the teams played pretty much even the rest of the way. That 8 points, Nancy, proved to be the final margin.
Well, I have to tell you, it's a much different West Virginia team. They lost 8 in a row. They backed into the tournament. If Providence had won, or they would not have been here because they had the tie for that last spot. But it's not the team that's playing who's the best. It's the team that's playing the best, and they are.
They have gotten red hot at just the right time. Montgomery in the front court, inside to Turner. As you would expect, this is a very biased Connecticut crowd here in the first miss of the game. Rebounded well by Sonny. Back the other way comes point guard Ashley Powell.
Well, that first possession, West Virginia went man-to-man, especially on Barb Turner, and Connecticut's staple of their defense is man-to-man as well.
Owens with the miss for West Virginia. Inside, strong move by Crockett. And Crockett will go to the free throw line. West Virginia, the number 12 seed, playing in their first ever Big East Conference Championship game. First in the school's history. And it caught their head coach a little bit off guard, admittedly, telling us that, hey, he only brought two suits, one for the banquet and one for the first round game.
And Mark, really the happening place last night after they knocked off Rutgers was the fifth floor of the Hilton. That's where the laundromat was. And they were all doing, scrambling to do laundry.
It's now become the lucky suit, Nancy, as Crockett knocks down the first free throw. Wilmette Crockett is a primetime player. Every year at the end of the year, the last three, 4 weeks, she really cranks her game up a notch. She gives Connecticut a 2-0 lead.
Connecticut just extending the pressure with a little 1-2-1-1. Not to steal, just to use clock. And they drop into their version of their 2-3. It can conform to a 3-2 zone.
On the baseline, it's Davis-White. Davis-White, the high scorer last night, got her own rebound. Run a little offense, Powell out top.
They're so much more equipped right now, West Virginia, to handle the loss of Meg Bolger, who will have surgery tomorrow at 6 a.m. That's what they're anticipating, because every play that was run this year or designed by Mike Carey was for her to get shots. Now others are assuming responsibility.
And so here's Sanni down to the block, kicks it back out to Cole. Cole with another miss, and West Virginia one and done at the offensive end. Montgomery back the other way. Tell us about the pace of the game, Nancy. If it's slow, it favors West Virginia, correct?
It's going to be very slow, and they'll take possessions away from Connecticut, who is the second highest scoring team in the Big East, to DePaul.
And Strother, meanwhile, driving to the bucket. She's fouled, and she'll go to the free throw line. Strother last night had 13 points in their victory. Good free throw shooter, right up around 88-89% for most of the season.
Just really have always enjoyed how she's played. She's not the type of kid that's going to seek a lot of the limelight. She's just steady. She now is the all-time leader in minutes. Second all-time, tied with Wendy Davis for three-pointers made in her career. Quietly ascending up the charts.
4-0, UConn with the lead. Powell breaking the press. Sanni trapped on the baseline, got a good look at it, but missing again. Montgomery pushing tempo. UConn with the rebound. UConn with a decided size advantage on West Virginia.
Yeah, they're pretty big on the perimeter, and they're very physical type of basketball players, but they run precision sets. They will read the defense. Look at that, Strother red. You shoot the gap, you fade to the corner.
And Strother knocks down the three ball. And this game starting very much like the previous one did, when UConn jumped out to that 8-0 lead before West Virginia and Mike Carey had to call a timeout to get the team back on track. Davis-White in the corner. And this one picked off by Strother. And Strother makes it 8-0 for UConn. And just like the previous game, UConn gets off to a very auspicious beginning against the Mountaineers.
And it's going to be very difficult for West Virginia to match if they get behind.
It has been a great magical run for the Mountaineers, but UConn ready to end it. We'll be back after this. Welcome back, everyone, to Championship Week presented by 7-Up. West Virginia down 8-0, part of the Big East Women's Championship presented by Aero Postal. And UConn out shooting 50% from the field, and Strother out of the gate quickly.
Well, it's not a surprise she's coming out. She has to be able to look for her shots, and she's so good at rebounding, at reading the defense. Watch her in the corner. This is a set play for her. If the defense, right here, shoots the gap, she fades to the corner, but she fades deep, so it's a two-slide recovery. She gets an open look.
And out of the timeout, West Virginia a little bit ragged in their offensive execution.
Mark, a lot of that is because of Connecticut's defense, one of the best in the country. They held DePaul to 39% shooting. They had 15 steals, and Connecticut shot 52%. They've got it working on all cylinders right now.
Go inside to Turner. No double team coming. Turner makes them pay down on the block, and UConn leading 10-0. West Virginia's got to be careful here. I know it's early, Nancy, but UConn right now looking pretty good.
It's really surprising me that they're not running somebody, a weak side guard, at Robert Turner, considering how hot she's been coming into the game, 71% shooting.
And Sanni gets West Virginia's first bucket. It's 10-2. West Virginia knocked off the number one seed last night, Rutgers, by a score of 56-40. And with West Virginia, Mike Carey's crew at the defensive end right now, good time to mention that all three of the opponents so far have been held to under 30% from the field.
We're really talking about 45 points a game.
Wow.
Some high scoring teams. And the fact that they've won three games in a row and haven't even hit 60 points speaks volumes of their defense.
Yelena Luchenka checked into the ball game during that last break for West Virginia, giving them a little size inside as Sanni came out of the ball game.
West Virginia never saw this look, never really saw the extended defense in the Rutgers game. They came down and they pretty much at will determined how they were going to play.
Inside to Luchenka. She got stripped by Strother. And back comes Montgomery. Quick hit ahead to Turner. Boy, great hands by Barb Turner, but she ran out of basketball court. Timeout on the floor. Barb Turner, last year the MVP of the conference championship tournament. Strother right now making a nice push for the same hardware. UConn's defense right now in education and anticipation. Strother with the deuce. We're back after this.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of Championship Week is presented by 7-Up. If you want 100% natural lemon and lime flavors, the only way to go is up.
Welcome back, everyone, to the capital of Connecticut. Championship Week presented by 7-Up. West Virginia down by 8 to number 7, UConn, with 15:54 to go. It's the Big East Women's Championship presented by Harold Postal and Mike Carey's team. Won the first game after losing arguably their best player and then proceeded to lose the next 8 in a row. They literally backed their way into this conference tournament. But well, they're making some things happen now.
Yeah, they are making it happen. You know, 3 in a row against really great opponents. Louisville, St. John's, and then number one Rutgers. You mentioned they didn't think they were going to get this far. They didn't pack enough clothing.
That's going to be a double dribble violation against the Mountaineers. But the phone calls keep coming in, the congratulatory ones for Mike Carey, the head coach, and several of his players. Tell you more about that in just a minute. Under 15 and a half minutes to go. Right now it's UConn, though, the story. Controlling the scoreboard and the play inside. That's going to be a foul against West Virginia.
Yeah, that's
Luchenka.
That's a tough matchup for her. Crockett's not going to score a lot of points, but she gets to the places on the floor that they need to be to execute.
Strother to inbound. Looking at that zone defense. Thomas. One and done. Powell with the rebound. Well, Thomas coming up that ankle injury, which kept her out for a few games before coming back 3 games ago. And Powell got stripped by Turner. Barb Turner to the bucket. With the putback. Barb Turner got it on the second try, and UConn shooting 50% from the field, still up in front, 12-2 now. Cole rejected by Crockett. Forced the second weapon, gets a trip to the free throw line as a result.
I have to tell you, Connecticut's changing defense is really bothering West Virginia right now. They do have a freshman point guard in Ashley Powell. But this is as close as they've gotten to that little orange thing on top and the block right here. Another opportunity for Cole to go hard to the rim.
Talked about some of those congratulatory phone calls. Cole telling us during shoot around this morning, but the guys on the men's basketball team have phoned. Frank Collins, Joey Bear, Mike Gamzee all called. Said it was very surprising because Joey Bear, the German, never talks, and they're ready to get going in a couple of days down to the Big East tournament, which begins tomorrow in New York.
Yeah, but they're pretty close. You know, last year the men's team was the number 8 seed. They went to Madison Square Garden in Big East finals. They ended up losing to Syracuse, but it really, they talked about it in the locker room the other day, saying that, you know, if the guys can do this, we can do it too.
And now they got to get going, down 10-2 after the misses at the free throw line.
Much better right here because Connecticut is not able to get the ball inside as easily. A 2-3 zone takes away anything on the baseline or inside.
And Nancy, with 2 seconds to go on the shot clock, they turn them over. Owens picks up her dribble. They'll double team off of Powell. She won't shoot it much. Owens will and comes up short. That might have been tipped. Dee Cantner says tipped, and it'll be West Virginia ball underneath.
Yeah, this ball was tipped. Look at the shot right here. Strother, 6'3", very long, contest shots.
Off the inbound, it's Owens. Cole looking into that zone. And now Davis-White fires away. She's still stone cold after notching 21 last night. And Soignier in a blur.
That's called jets. You put Soignier in the game. You push Montgomery to the wing. She's more of a shooting guard. And now you have a really quick backcourt.
12-3 for UConn. And you have to wonder, with 4 games in as many days, how much of a factor is fatigue going to be here early?
Well, I would run. I would push tempo if I'm Connecticut, try and catch the zone before it sets up.
And that Crockett with great work underneath on the offensive glass. Get an extra possession out of it, approaching 13 minutes to go here in the first half. It's been all Connecticut, shooting 50% from the field. Montgomery out top with 10 on the shot clock. Got a screen from Crockett. That one partially blocked. Nice defensive play by Owens.
You made a comment before about Powell. They play off her a lot. She is really not going to shoot the ball. She only averages 2.5 points a game. She is here to just set people up. The other night, she played 33 minutes. Even though she really didn't score, she only had one turnover. She got the ball to the right people, and that's what Mike Carey wants.
And with that, Nancy, Wilnett Crockett will sit down. Brittany Hunter comes into the ball game. Houston to inbound.
What a game Hunter had the other night. 8 points in 10 minutes, 4 for 5.
Former transfer from Duke, bouncing back after ACL surgery a couple of years ago. Strother open in the corner, this time off the mark. And a good block out on the rebound. Outside of Luchenka, West Virginia decidedly smaller. They get a clean look and unable to capitalize once again. That time, Davis-White, another miss. Montgomery with the pull-up. And it is all Huskies right now, leading 16-3.
I so like Montgomery's game. She is going to be among the leaders of all time for freshmen in steals and assists. She can shoot the basketball.
And they get a good look that time, an easy one, Luchenka.
Isn't that what Geno needed a year ago? He was playing point guard by committee. I think he's found his point guard for the next 3+ years.
Former McDonald's High School All-American. It's interesting that a freshman could come into a program like this and make such an indelible mark in her first year, doing it once again, this time a little bit strong. And rebounded by West Virginia. We have a timeout on the court. Montgomery leading the troops right now, making great decisions on the break. Number 20 dropping a pair. We'll be back after this. And Strother leading the way as UConn leads by 11. It's Championship Week presented by 7-Up. Big East Women's Championship presented by Aeropostale. And this year marks the 25th anniversary of the NCAA Women's Championship. Now to celebrate, we're counting down the top 25 championship moments, revealing number one in the championship game, April the 4th. Time now to spotlight moment number 12, brought to you by Singular. Just how good were they? Only perfect. In 1995, Connecticut defeated Tennessee 70-64 in the national championship game. The Huskies had it all that season: speed, power, character, and chemistry. And with the win, they also had perfection, a record of 35 wins, no losses, and a permanent spot in the history books. A pensive and thoughtful-looking Geno Auriemma on the sidelines. Decidedly a little calmer than we've seen him in the past, Nancy.
You know what? He continues to mature and grow into his game and coaching abilities as players do. You win 5 national championships. He's now going to be inducted and enshrined in the Women's Basketball Hall of Fame. He will be inducted. He's a finalist, one of the 16 finalists for the Naismith Basketball Hall of Fame. He's calm. He knows his place in history, and he's really done a great job of coaching this team.
And he's got the book out, too. That's the whole package, right?
Yeah, he didn't make me pay for the book, but he didn't autograph it.
Still waiting for my copy. The ball knocked out of bounds. Mountaineer basketball underneath.
That'll cost you $23.95. Jonesy.
All? Is that all?
He signs it. It's more.
Waiting for the ESPN discount. He is a part-time employee, I thought. On the wing, it's Powell. Play a little inside out. West Virginia's Cole still looking to find her stroke offensively. And Montgomery, a little bit of contact, no foul. Cardi Houston missing that last tip. Back come the Mountaineers with just 5 points on the board so far.
Good, solid defense. Man-to-man this time. They do a great job. They're very long and lengthy.
Boy, they get another good look. Cole had it roll off the rim. Strother looked inside at first. They're looking for Hunter. Nice high-low. Hunter finally gets it. And she lost the handle, but it'll stay UConn basketball as Mel Thomas gets set to come back into the ball game for UConn along with Barbara Turner and Wilnett Crockett.
So deep. And that's the other thing, is that Connecticut is tremendously deep. They can go 8-9 players. Coach Carey, he's got about 7. he can't go much past that. Tamika Kelly, she did shoot around today, but she also had that semi-concussion prior to the semifinal game. Did not play yesterday against Rutgers.
And if you're West Virginia right now, you're wondering to what happened to those 12,000 fans here in Connecticut that were cheering for us last night.
No.
Well, that's because they were more hating on Rutgers than cheering for West Virginia. One on the shot clock. UConn barely gets it off, and that's going to be a shot clock violation.
Isn't that what Shakia Cole was telling us before the game at shoot around today? She goes, you know, it was amazing. I was in the huddle one time, and I was looking around, and they were doing our cheer, and they were pulling for us. I didn't even hear what Coach Carey said.
Yeah, different story here tonight. Up top to Luchenka. She fires away. The import from Belarus missing that time, and UConn controlling the backboard so far. Thomas on the wing. Good block by Owens. That's going to be a foul against Connecticut. UConn with their second team foul with 9:24 to play in the first half.
Owens does a really nice job of matching up to the hand of the shooter. She's long at 5'9". If you're going to do that, you got to pump fake her and get her arm out of there.
West Virginia comes into this ball game 15-15 after losing 8 straight coming into the conference tournament. They've upsetted 3 higher seeds. They were the number 12 of 12 seeds coming in, defeating number 5, number 4, then number 1. They have to win to make it to the NCAA tournament. 6 on the shot clock, and the jumper good by Laquita Owens. If they lose in this championship game, they will not go to the tournament.
They will not go to the tournament, but if they do, it's because of Laquita Owens. Her first 18 games, she averaged 4.4 points a game. The last set of games until this time, tournament time, she's averaged over 12 points a game. She's really picked it up.
Owens moved into the starting lineups when they lost Meg Bulger to the knee injury. We mentioned she's going to have surgery tomorrow sometime. She was here yesterday cheering her teammates on, and there's the stark contrast in the last 12 games between the first ones that she played.
But, you know, you can't be the type of team that sits there and says, oh, my gosh, we lost a really great player. It's an opportunity for you to get more playing time. There's more shots to be distributed.
Yes.
And they've risen to the occasion.
Yeah, if you're a West Virginia player, you're thinking, well, somebody's got to take those 18 to 20 jacks that Bulger took every game. As Strother comes back into the ball game.
But you know, Mark, it's the other thing with a player's mentality. At this time of the year, you have to have the confidence to make plays. And if you do, you win.
Well, right now, the Mountaineers down by 8. Just feels like a lot more than that because of the tempo of the game. Powell out top. Montgomery daring her to shoot. Runner in the lane, a little bit strong by Davis-White, and they get it back. That's going to be an offensive foul called against West Virginia and Shakia Cole. Timeout on the floor with 7:52 to go in the first half. Mike Carey trying to formulate a little strategy. And we're going to take a short break. And on the other side of this, we'll be back in the studio for a Championship Week studio update.
Trey Wingo here in our basketball studios updating you on the men's Mid-Continent Conference final. Chicago State comes in as a 6th seed, 11-18, but Richard Galley with the jumper. They're up on top-seeded Oral Roberts at the break. Back to Hartford. Mark, Nancy, take it away.
All right, Trey, back here. Championship week presented by 7-Up. 16-8, West Virginia leading in the Big East Women's Championship presented by Aero Postal. 7:52 to go in the first half, and look at the plunging shooting percentages, Nancy. You come to the conclusion that, hey, West Virginia, despite just 3 of 19 from the field, are very much in this game.
Well, what they do is if you allow them to hang around, they have the ability because they get to the foul line, they go hard to the rim, and they can hit the three, they can get back in basketball games.
And with that, a turnover by UConn because of the staunch defense by West Virginia. UConn turnover. Interesting to watch Luchenka in the ball game. We haven't seen much of Sanni since the first 5-7 minutes. What do you make of that move?
Well, she's played really well, but Luchenka does a good job on the board. She can step out and hit the shot that Sanni can't away from the basket.
Sanni, Luchenka posting up big inside there, trying to get it to her in a tough pass. That was way too hot from Powell. Now back to UConn. They haven't scored a hoop since the 11:54 mark.
Well, that's just about the time that West Virginia went from man-to-man to their zone. And Connecticut is now settling for these outside shots, and they haven't been hitting them instead of penetrating the gaps, either looking for the short jumper or finding the opposite corner.
That time it was Mel Thomas with the miss. Nice little show and go by Owens. Luchenka kicks it back out. They repost it to her. Nice move by Luchenka, and she'll go to the free throw line. That time, they were able to, you know what, when a big works that hard, you have to get her a touch at least inside. ESPN's coverage of the Big East Championship kicks off tomorrow afternoon live. Madison Square Garden, first two round games, and at noon, it's Syracuse against Cincinnati, then Notre Dame takes on Georgetown. Big East Championship presented by Aero Postal is part of Championship Week presented by 7-Up. On ESPN tomorrow, and Cincinnati coming off a very big home win in their last game.
Well, I'm very impressed with Luchenka because she got such deep position underneath. She can turn, and she's got that baby hook with the right and the baby hook with the left, and she's a great story. She's an inspiration. She's coming off of two ACLs, one in one knee, and then tears it in the next knee the year after.
Having to learn an entirely different culture as well. Not only coming to the United States, but living in West Virginia, right?
Yeah.
That's two different cultures.
And the culture,
some would say.
The culture of rehab as well.
And I mean that in a very flattering way for those of you in Morgantown and beyond. 16-10 with 6:13 to go.
What about the fans in Belarus?
And that too. We're up about 50 miles from Chernobyl. She posts up big again. Nice left-handed move inside, and Luchenka bringing West Virginia within 4 points. The Mountaineers in the midst of a 9-0 run in the last 7 minutes. Here's Turner wheeling on the block. And Luchenka with the rebound.
Connecticut has stopped moving the basketball. They're taking the first available shot.
Cinderella in navy blue and gold. That one halfway down and out by Davis-White. She's having a tough time tonight from the field. 0 for 4.
Okay, clearly the pressure's on Connecticut because they're supposed to win their 13th tournament here. There is no pressure on West Virginia, so it's easy for those guys to just put shots up. They're just happy to be here and do laundry.
No doubt. A couple more clean shirts for their head coach, Carey, and they'll be set. They come in 15-15. They've knocked off the number 5 seed, number 4 seed, and number 1 seed already in this tournament. Still hunting big game. That shot off the mark by Owens. 5 minutes to go in the first half. Montgomery. Strother. Boy, halfway down and out again. Luchenko with another rebound.
But this has been a shootout because Connecticut in the first two games has shot well over 50% and had high percentage shots.
Now dig this, Nancy. West Virginia shooting 18% from the field, down 4 against Connecticut.
But that's about to drop a little bit lower right now.
Owens off the mark.
Look at the positions the 6'5 senior from Belarus gets. Right here, you must do early work in the post. And she reads the D quick enough to split it. I said she can go right or left. And she's got great touch around the rim.
Talk about her skills on the court, off the court. She had to learn English by listening to R&B and rap CDs.
That's how I learned.
That's a different language.
What's wrong with that?
On the baseline, Davis-White. Still can't find it. Now 0 for 6 from the field, and she has gotten some point-blank looks. Little inside out. Turner out to Shardae Houston. And Houston lost the handle. They give it right back. Shardae Houston continues to be a perplexing player for Geno Auriemma. So talented, but sometimes need a different Shardae Houston.
Well, it's feast or famine. She's either going to give you brilliance or she's going to give you a lot of gray hair.
Had a chance to visit with her mother in the hotel lobby last night. A very engaging lady. Luchenko coming over the top. That's going to be a foul as Barb Turner had it blocked out nicely. But the lead is down to 4 points, a tenuous 4 points for UConn. With 3:46 to go in the first half of play, we've got a timeout. And the Huskies as frigid right now as the Connecticut night outside the Civic Center. Back after this.
Trey Wingo here with Doris Burke coming up with the 7-Up Halftime Report. We've got the latest in basketball, the NFL, and Barry Bonds. Plus, tournament's just a week away for the women, Doris.
We'll tell you who's hot and who's not.
All that coming up. We'll see if UConn can get hot and make a shot before the end of the half is over. Let's send it back to the Civic Center in Hartford. Mark and Nancy, take it away.
Just up by 84 from you guys, Trey. Championship week presented by 7-Up. It's the Big East Women's Championship presented by Aeropostale. And stepping to the free throw line, Barb Turner, who once again playing some of her best basketball at the right time of the season. The 6-foot senior from Cleveland, averaging a little under 10 points per game, missing from the free throw line. And back comes West Virginia with a chance to cut the lead to 2.
This is a nightmare for Geno Auriemma and his coaching staff, because not only are they not getting shots that are falling, they're not getting to the foul line, which they do so much during the course of the season. Mark, these guys have been averaging 70 points in the 2 games they've played thus far.
That's going to be an offensive foul, Nancy, as Davis-White drove to the basket. And UConn, as you mentioned, a very prolific team offensively right now, well below their offensive pace.
They're not the team that's going to have one guy get 25 points. They are a very balanced offensive team where you got to get 10, 15 double figures from 3 or 4 people.
Look at the seniors here for a little bit of leadership. Strother, one of them, and Turner, a couple of seniors. They almost turned it over. 10 on the shot clock. Montgomery into traffic. 4 on the shot clock for Turner. Montgomery, one of the smallest players on the floor, with the putback. And that snaps a long drought for Connecticut. 2:45 to go in the first half. Powell's done a nice job handling the pressure here of Connecticut.
You know, because Connecticut didn't score for so long, they were not able to put their full court pressure on. They like to do it off a score, off a dead ball, or off a made foul shot.
Cross court and inside. Good block on the play as Powell went for the layup. It'll be Mountaineer basketball with 2:22 to go in the first half. West Virginia coming in 15-15 overall. A win sends them to the NCAA tournament. And the bucket good by Luchenko. She has come off the bench for Sanni and done a wonderful job for them, keeping them in the basketball game. Luchenko right now, 2 of 4 from the field, 6 points. Houston coming over the back. That's going to be a foul. And that is the 16th foul against Connecticut. The Big East Championship continues tomorrow night on ESPN with a double dip live from Madison Square Garden. Rutgers taking on Seton Hall. Gary Waters coaching perhaps his last game for Rutgers in Louisville, taking on number 16, Pittsburgh. Rick Pitino has come out and said, hey, listen, we need to win 3 games and we'll be in. So is his belief anyway.
I don't think you're believing that.
I'm not so sure.
I'm not either. It's been a rough year for Louisville.
Davis-White has not made a shot from the field yet, out of bounds. And the Connecticut basketball as Cole took a hard fall and got back up. Good news for West Virginia because they are not a deep team.
No, they're not a deep team, but they are very much an energy team. They give so much effort. They dive after loose balls. They do exactly what we just saw in the corner, and it allows them to stay in games. And where they play this zone as well as anybody. Now they've switched to man-to-man.
Strother came off the screen, an illegal screen set by Brittany Hunter. And that is now the 16th foul against UConn. With 1:32 to go in the first half.
You know, credit the defense because sometimes the defender can push the offensive player off the curl of their screen. Brittany Hunter was just trying to do her job, was to get Ann Strother open.
And it looks like, Nancy, we're going to have Cole go to the bench and be tended to by someone on their medical staff. He's taking out the gloves. Appears as if that would indicate there's blood present. Well, Booker comes into the ball game off the bench, number 12 from the same high school as Meg Bulger. Chance to cut it to 2. And they turn it over with a golden opportunity to get a little bit closer. Soigne, good ball movement to Montgomery from the corner, knocking down the 3. That's a big swing for West Virginia.
Yeah, that's huge. But Renee Montgomery, she's a freshman of the year in the Big East. She's been better, in my opinion, than advertised and plays with tremendous confidence. Look at the extra pass. Well, right here, this is the save ball, the replay before that. Look right here. See the extra pass? Strother throws the defense and gave her teammate an open look.
Montgomery making good on the opportunity. Montgomery 3 of 8 from the field, 7 points so far as Cole coming back into the ball game. Bukar comes out as Luchenko will come to the free throw line. Talked about her coming from Belarus, formerly from Seminole and Wabash Junior Colleges, played at both junior colleges, and mentioned that she learned to speak English by listening to rap CDs. You know, I thought that when we spoke with her, she sounded a little bit like Snoop. I was a little concerned.
What was the word she used?
She said for shizzle.
For shizzle. But she had it with a little accent. And she is here. She's quite a story. She's the best shot blocker on this basketball team, and she's just played well. She's had 11 games where she's been in double figures. She gives them what they need.
A little bit surprising to have Sanni on the bench this long for most of the first half. She's their leading scorer without bulging. She averages 12 and a half a game, so we're getting it from another source, and that's going to be a traveling violation against UConn. A chance now for West Virginia to get within 3 with 40.5 seconds to go.
And he puts Barbara Turner in a little bit for defense here. Brittany Hunter goes to the bench, and you really have to be mindful of the matchups and the substitutions in a tight game like this.
West Virginia shooting 18% from the field. And there's exhibit A as to why. Another miss from outside from Owens. And the foul going to be against Ashley Powell. And West Virginia is over the number. UConn will go to the free throw line.
Wasn't a bad thought by the freshman Powell, but she went to the player instead of attacking the ball and cutting the angle of the pass off.
Montgomery going to the free throw line, the precocious freshman from St. Albans, West Virginia, the former high school teammate of Alexis Hornbuckle. And speaking of Hornbuckle in Tennessee, big win against LSU. What do you think about that, Nancy?
That's a huge win. It might get them their number one seed back. I don't think anybody thought they would be able to go and play that type of a game, but they made it a half-court game, and they took away the speed and the athleticism of LSU.
West Virginia with 19 seconds to go in the half, down by 7 points. Mountaineers have lost 16 straight games against UConn after winning one.
Yeah, Powell's got to pass the ball. Instead, she's going to end up with a turnover here.
They got a rush now, and they're a little bit disconcerted. 2 seconds to go, and that's the type of shot they get. Davis-White coming up short. As West Virginia just 1-16 all time against UConn, their last win in 82. Defense the order of the day. Hey, Trey Wingo, as far as offense is concerned, these two teams couldn't play dead in a cowboy movie right now. Back to you.
Wow, Mark Jones, thanks for that creative talk. We appreciate it. Welcome into the 7-Up Halftime Report. Trey Wingo here with Doris Burke. And this is a theme that has really been a problem for UConn all season long, Doris. In fact, it's very reminiscent of the last game you called between UConn and Rutgers down at the Rack in New Jersey, where UConn at one point went, 11 minutes, not without scoring a field goal, without scoring a point.
You can go all the way back to last season and know that the one side of the basketball that has pinched this team throughout the course of the last 2 years is the offensive end. They have always been solid on the defensive side of the ball. Even through those 5 national titles, they were always a very hard team to score against. That used to get lost, Trey, because they were so good and so fun to watch on the offensive
end.
But steady defense is what this team has been at staple. On the offensive end, they can go long stretches without making a shot. You'd think with experienced players like Barbara Turner and Ann Strother, offense would not be a struggle. But the reality is this team takes poor shots. In this particular instance, don't even get a shot off. This has got to be something that gets better through the course of the NCAA tournament if this team's going to have a chance to compete for a national title.
Again, this is a team that probably, in all likelihood, if they win this game, may lock up a number one seed in the NCAA tournament, yet they still don't have one go-to scorer that they can rely on in crunch time.
Correct. They've got a plethora of scorers, but nobody who they look to for any one particular shot. That's what they need.
All right, we'll see if UConn can get back on track, see if the West Virginia miracle can continue. They win, they get into the tournament. Second half coming up.
Welcome back to the 7-Up Halftime Report.
Trey Wingo, Doris Burke here with you in our studios at the Half Pacific Center in Hartford. UConn leading West Virginia by 7, 23-16. UConn went a long time without a bucket late in that first half. Can the dream for the Mountaineers continue? Can they win and get into the NCAAs? Other teams trying to get their Mid-Continent Conference, Oakland and Western Illinois on a 4-to-play. Oakland up 7. Jane Wilson. Turn, spin, and one. Gets a tough bucket. Oakland up 58-49. Now under 2 minutes to play, Oakland up 6. Wilson, nice bounce pass to Lakeisha White. She will put it up and in. Oakland wins 65-56, upsetting top-seeded Western Illinois and advancing to the NCAA. So who's in? Here we go. Let's run them down. Chattanooga, Marist, Middle Tennessee, North Carolina, Oakland, Ohio State, and Pepperdine. Also, Southeast Missouri State, Temple, Tennessee, Tulsa, UCLA, and Wisconsin, Milwaukee out of the Horizon Conference. Time for what to watch for now as we get set for the tournament. And Doris, I want to know what's percolating over there. Let's start with some teams that we've been dealing with all season long. Let's start with Duke. What's their confidence like going in, having struggled against North Carolina, then losing to Maryland in the ACC tourney?
Well, I think that's probably the biggest factor for teams at this time of the year. How are you feeling about yourself? And people will wonder, they've lost 2 of 3. But let's remember, they lost 2 of 3 to excellent teams. North Carolina has been atop the polls all season long. Maryland, a young team, but burgeoning with confidence. So this is a Duke team that is going to practice for 2 weeks. Gail Guest, of course, says, listen, we play our best basketball when we have a chip on our shoulders. You want to talk about a team brimming with confidence? How about the Ohio State Buckeyes? 19 straight wins. Their only 2 losses without Ashley Allen at 100%. She drains the 3 there. The reality for the Buckeyes, though, because the Big Ten lesser teams were not great because of injuries, they will probably get a number 2 seed. That's the reality of it, especially if the Connecticut Huskies win. And their future, I think, hinges on the guard play. Renee Montgomery and Keisha Soigne are very talented basketball players. We saw in the first half, Soigne can change
push
the pace
up the floor,
of the game.
Yeah.
So fast. changes the speed at which they play. And Montgomery is as talented physically as any freshman point guard they've had. Her question mark is, will she focus and play the mental game for the full 40 minutes? LSU, a possible number one seed. You wonder if it comes down to them in Connecticut. Does that head-to-head matchup and the win by Connecticut, you know, put them over the top? But Simone Augustus, she's got a chance, Trey, to finish her legacy, put a stamp on it. Will she change LSU's history and win that first national title? She's got a shot.
I'll tell you, really interesting. If UConn struggles in this game, let's say they only win by 3 or 4, does that lean it towards Ohio State now to get that final number one seed, in your opinion?
I think it does. Jim Foster's team has done everything you could ask. It is not their problem that there were some injuries for the lower teams in the Big Ten. They've won every game. They beat Oklahoma. I think this team is absolutely worthy of a one.
Yeah, 19 straight wins is about the definition of doing everything you possibly can to lock up that number one seed. And even though they gave away the big lead against Purdue in the Big Ten championship, they came back and managed to find the bucket at the end when they needed it.
Welcome back, everyone, to the Civic Center in Hartford, Connecticut, Championship Week, presented by 7-Up. The Big East Women's Championship presented by Aero Postal. Connecticut leading by 7. I'm Mark Jones, along with the Hall of Famer. They used to call her Lady Magic, Nancy Lieberman. Nancy, nothing magical about this first half for West Virginia. When you look at their last game, Cole and Davis-White combined for 19 and 21 points respectively. A different story. This isn't the Rutgers game for them.
Well, we're talking about 1 for 23 from these three players who must give offense to West Virginia. I don't know where they'd be without Luchenko, who came off the bench and gave 10 tough points out of West Virginia's 16.
They got off to a slow start, falling behind 8-0 to start the game, but that's a good sign. Sanni back in the ballgame. She rarely played in the first half. She only put in about 8 minutes in the first half, but she gets the first bucket, and West Virginia down by 5.
You know, sometimes you have to play on instinct, and instinct was the fact that Luchenko played really well. She played 16 minutes, and she was 3 of 5 from the field.
10 on the shot clock, Strother. Nice ball fake. There's going to be a foul underneath. It's against Connecticut. It's against Wilnett Crockett. Well, they ran a nice play out of the first sequence. See what they get this time down, the Mountaineers. Inside to Sanni.
Yeah, I think they have to go inside. If they're going to play you man-to-man, give her some opportunities around the basket.
Montgomery lost control, and that's going to be out of bounds. UConn basketball, as Davis-White couldn't get a handle on it.
And Mark, where would UConn be in the first half without the stellar play of Montgomery, who had 9 points and only one turnover in 19 minutes?
Now, both of these teams pulled from the field. Strother from deep outside, and rebound West Virginia. UConn shooting just 29% from the field, and West Virginia just 17%. The Mountaineers making a concerted effort to go inside, and it cashes in once again. Sanni with her second field goal of the half and her second of the game.
I would go there early and often and either get an opportunity or get a foul, but look at this play right here.
Davis-White on the move, and here come the Mountaineers. They're within 1 point, and they have come out of the gate here in the second half with bad intentions. Geno Auriemma calls timeout.
This is exactly the nightmare that Geno Auriemma did not want to live.
Davis-White on the move after the steal with some crazy acceleration. It's a 1 point game in a blink. It's championship week presented by 7-Up. Connecticut leading West Virginia by a point. And the Big East Women's Championship presented by Aero Postal. And here's a look at the seeding. Number 12, West Virginia, taking on number 2, UConn this year. That is the big story. Number 12, West Virginia, the last seed, making it all the way to the championship game for the first time in tournament history.
Well, the number 5, Syracuse, won back in 1985, so it can happen, but wow, a 12th seed that backed into the tournament?
L. Thomas off the mark. Strong rebound by Sanni. And now an opportunity for the Mountaineers to continue that 6-0 run and take the lead on this possession. Mike Carey calling out the play from the sidelines. Montgomery spearheading the UConn defense in a man defense now. They've had a lot of success going inside to Sanni. Crockett fronting her on the post.
Yeah, great job on the inside by Wilnett, working very hard. It's hard to get around Sanni.
Get it knocked away. Bad pass inside. And UConn gives it right back to West Virginia.
If the ball goes into the post, Sanni has to know that Connecticut is running that opposite player at her, the opposite post. It's either a kick back out, reverse it, and let her get it on the other side when she resets.
See what they do this time down. Olayinka Sanni. Olayinka means wealth around me in Africa. Right now she's got some determined teammates around her getting her the basketball.
See, I think you have to take Powell away from Sonny's side, because if not, you just sit there, you're sitting on her lap.
And a bad result that time as Cole gets called for the offensive foul. That's her second personal foul, and for West Virginia, the first team foul of the half. Had a good look at it, and a nervous cheer coming now from Connecticut fans at the Hartford Civic Center.
Connecticut's going to run a play right here. It's an elbow play for Barbara Turner. They run all this away from her. And that time Strother thought she had a shot, but they try and run that where you curl off the elbow shot.
West Virginia has knocked off the number 5 seed, the number 4 seed, the number 1 seed. Trying for the big fish right here. Again with UConn, the number 2 seed. A win tonight for the Mountaineers. They go to the NCAA tournament. Looking for the lead. 10 on the shot clock. Sanni inside. Another good look, but a miss once again. They are getting fantastic shots, though. Turner looking for the pass inside for Crockett.
Well, the player that needs the ball is Barbara Turner.
Yeah.
You know, Wilnett Crockett, she's the dirty type of player. She's going to get the rebound. She's going to do all the little dirty work, set the screens. You've got to start running Barbara Turner either to the block or looking at some face-up shots.
Right now, they'll have to wait. They're on defense. West Virginia with another chance to take the lead. This is their fourth game in as many days. But they've come out with a lot of vigor for the lead, and coming up short again is Cole.
It's a good shot by Cole, because she's that undersized post and she can take you away from the rim.
Well, the second half starting like the first half ended. She's 0-for-9 from the field now. Strother with 15 on the shot clock.
Man-to-man defense by West Virginia. They're switching it up on Connecticut right now.
And Strother drills one from 16 feet for the 3-point lead. And Strother, one of 4 seniors for UConn, playing in their last Big East championship game.
And what a senior class it is. They've only won 121 games and lost 17, 88%.
Wow.
2 national championships. Crockett, Wolf, Turner, and Strother have a lot to be proud of.
Owens kicks it back out, 5 on the shot clock. Sanni, they got to shoot it. Powell, not the person you want left open with time winding down to the shot clock. After clawing to within 1, West Virginia down by 3 as Connecticut does them a favor, throwing it away. We have a timeout, and concern etched across the face of Geno Auriemma, but her senior star to try and bail out the Huskies with more of those when we come back. Connecticut leading by 3, championship week presented by 7-Up. Part of the Big East Women's Championship presented by Aeropostale. And Nancy, interesting what's happening in the half court with West Virginia.
Well, if you're going to want to go inside to Sanni, then I think right here, if Montgomery is shoulder to shoulder with the post, you've got to be able to send Powell, in my opinion, get her out of there and rotate a shooter to that side, because right now Montgomery is pretty much in a prevent defense. Matter of fact, that's Soignier right there, but they're sitting on the lap of the post, and she's not going to get the touches you want if you don't make that defender come out and guard the perimeter.
It's pretty crowded in there when you have one person that really can't make shots. And this time they have Owens on Sonny's side of the floor, so they seem to be remedying that, at least temporarily.
And plus, you know, they've switched it a little bit for Connecticut.
Seven on the shot clock. Davis-White lets it fly, and she has had a rough night. Has not made but one shot. She's one of 10 from the field. Sanni back the other way. Sharday Houston lets it go. West Virginia hanging around despite shooting just 22% from the field. And that's going to be a foul against UConn. Cole going to the free throw line, where she is a 68% free throw shooter. That's the second team foul against UConn. UConn won the earlier meeting between these two sides, 58-50, back in January, as Cole misses the first of two. ESPN's coverage of the Big East Championship kicks off tomorrow afternoon live from Madison Square Garden. Syracuse takes on Cincinnati. Notre Dame taking on Georgetown in the second of the doubleheader at 2 o'clock Eastern time. Big East Championship presented by Aeropostale, part of Championship Week presented by 7-Up on ESPN tomorrow. I'm jumping in the car tonight.
You are going.
Driving down to NYC.
You get your directions. You know exactly where you're going. And Cole knew exactly where she was going. The last two games in this tournament, she's 13 of 15 from the foul line, shooting 88%.
The lead is 2 for the Huskies. Turner trawled for the travel. Looked like there might have been a reach. And West Virginia with another opportunity to tie as Sanni goes to the bench and Luchenka comes in. Remember, Luchenka had 10 points in the first half of the Mountaineers. She had a very successful first half.
Now, Mark, you made a comment that in the last game UConn won, but they had a 10-point lead at halftime. West Virginia played them pretty much straight up in the second half, so there was some comfortability and success.
Luchenka was jockeying for position. As a result, Barbara Turner got called for the foul. That's the third team foul against Connecticut. Green comes out of the ball game. For the lead, Luchenka with the rebound, and she's fouled by Soigne. So the fouls mounting up here early in the second half. That's the fourth team foul against Connecticut.
Well, Luchenka was a force to be reckoned with in the first half. She had 10 points. She was able to do it both with defense. She got on the glass. And she was able to get great position underneath a couple times early.
We have a jump ball situation after the tie-up. And the possession arrow in favor of Connecticut.
Okay, are we in agreement that Connecticut is playing for a number 2 seed in the NCAA tournament?
I would say that.
And the depth of this conference is unbelievable. There's 11 teams in the top 65 of the RPI, and no conference really has that type of depth. You know, I think it's illustrated by the number 12 seed advancing to the finals.
Right, you can get all the seedings on Selection Monday, less than a week away now on ESPN at 7:30 p.m. next Monday. Barb Turner driving to the bucket, gets it to fall. When in doubt, put it in the hands of your senior playmaker and let her go to work. It's a 4-point lead, Turner with 6.
Well, I really think that Rutgers, Connecticut, DePaul, and St. John's are a lock for the tournament, and certainly Notre Dame, Pittsburgh, Villanova, Louisville, South Florida, those would be bubble teams.
Well, the Big East has somewhat dominated the women's championship going back a few years. The 3 in a row by Connecticut, the win by Notre Dame in the Ruth Riley years. The Big East has had a nice run of late.
Yeah, Baylor kind of broke up the block party, if you will. But it is kind of amazing. But you think about it, I mean, the Big East now is the Big East and Conference USA, so it wouldn't surprise me if they got 7 or 8 teams in the tournament. They did that back in 2004. Last year they had 4 teams in.
Strother. Here's Strother from outside. Turner to Houston. Geno calls out the play. And Houston with a nice feed to Montgomery. Sharday Houston making it happen. Little draw and dish. And the lead has swollen back up to 6. Montgomery with 11 now. Their first bucket of the second half.
Connecticut's eyes just light up when they see man-to-man defense.
And boy, Nancy, Davis-White cannot make a shot tonight. Her and Owens a combined 2 of 20 from the field.
Well, if they don't have that firepower, even if they knock down 2 or 3 threes, it's going to give them what they need.
Cinderella looking for one last miracle, but Montgomery thinking otherwise for UConn. Back after this. Welcome back, everyone, to the Civic Center in Hartford. UConn, rated number 7 in the country, leading West Virginia, the Cinderella of championship week so far. They've upset the 5 seed, the 4 seed, and the number 1 seed to get this far, evening the record of 15-15 on the season. But it'll be all for naught if they don't win this game, because there will be no tournament berth if they don't win.
Mark, Cinderella's going to have to trade in a shoe for a jumper, okay? I think I would pull the trigger on that one, because right now, the 3 guards that they depend on to score are 2 of 29.
Wow. That's in stark contrast to the success they had last night, knocking off the number 1 seed Rutgers. Donnie at the free throw line, missing the 1st of 2. Talked about all the congratulatory phone calls they received. She called her father in Nigeria at about $3 a minute, I might add, and spoke for about 7 minutes, she told me, during shoot-around, that said that her father didn't even believe that they had gotten this far in the tournament. He had to get onto the internet, because I didn't know they didn't have ESPN or ESPNU in Nigeria. We got to work on that.
Yeah, no, I told her to have her dad call her cable operator and ask for ESPNU.
Soignier knocks down the 3-ball. And the lead is back up to 8. This is as much breathing room as UConn has had in the second half as we approach 11 minutes to go.
Keisha does not shoot the ball a lot. She's more of a push tempo and defend player.
So they are daring Powell to shoot still.
There is a battle of the beast going on underneath the basket between Sanni.
Meanwhile, Cole gets the bucket to go.
And was it Houston? I mean, they are going at it defensively.
Out top, it's Soignier. Houston posting up inside. And that's going to be an offensive foul against Sharday Houston. Dee Kantner making the call, and Geno immediately calls for Brittany Hunter to get her off the bench. That's the 3rd personal foul against Sharday Houston, pardon me. She's had moments of brilliance, sorry, Nancy, like the one earlier this year in December against LSU, where she literally took the game over and won the game for UConn. But then there are nights like tonight where she just can't get it going.
Well, she has that type of next-level skill. But, you know, right here, Sanni has to be thinking to herself, okay, they just took out 6'1 Houston, and they put in 6'3 Hunter. Where does it end for me tonight?
No break, no naps. Up top, Soignier. Hunter on the block. Sanni with the rebound and a chance to get back to within 2. At some point, do you think Powell's going to have to actually take a shot and make one with the way that they lay off her sometimes? Nice spin move inside. Cole couldn't finish. Sanni couldn't get it back. And that's going to be a foul against West Virginia. It almost looked like, and Mike Carey is saying, that the UConn player pivoted right into Sanni.
Well, Dee Kantner was right there on the baseline, and I know she was just trying to create some space, Barb Turner, and you're supposed to do this as a big. You know what? Every rebound means something. The beautiful spin right here by Cole, misses the shot, trying to go right back up, anticipating the foul. Right here, Barb Turner saying, she kept her elbows in. I think she did a great job of creating space.
Soignier with the drive. Turner inside. Got it back to Soignier for 3. Different result this time. And the frigid shooting continues. UConn at 30%. West Virginia at 22%. And that's an improvement, folks.
You know, and these are the things, it doesn't matter how
nice backdoor cut.
How much you execute, and that's a beautiful read because she was defended and denied, and Davis-White took the cut to the rim.
Back to a two-point game, under 9 minutes to go here. The championship game in the Big East Conference. Number 12 seed West Virginia, the lowest seed ever to make it to the title game against UConn. Strother with the miss and a chance to tie or go ahead with a three.
I have to tell you, that was great defense. You have to go over the top of those screens on Montgomery. You go underneath them against Soigne.
Gotta be thinking Sanni inside. Cole kicks it back out. A force on the shot, and man, did Davis-White go down hard. She doesn't have much choice but to get back up because that is not a deep West Virginia bench. Brittany Davis-White from Houston, a 5'7 junior. One more look at the fall.
Just look how hard she goes up with the shot, and then she's really lucky that her hair kind of took the brunt of the fall, but she was 14 of 20 in the game against Rutgers. 25% of all her foul shots in the season came in that basketball game. She had only taken 61 until that game.
Getting pretty comfortable with the free throw line, I guess you're trying to say, huh? As she makes the first of two, Luchenko coming back into the ball game for Sanni. Davis-White, an 82% free throw shooter. She's a junior, but her first year in the program here at West Virginia, that underscores the fact that this is a very young team. They started freshmen, a junior in her first year, and three sophomores, and they just missed the tie. UConn has led the entire way. They jumped out to an 8-0 lead and haven't looked back. Houston back in the ballgame with a little ball fake. Strother from 18, and she knocks it down. And Strother for Connecticut. With 3 of 11 from the field, 8 points.
Strother and Barb Turner are going to have to be mindful that they have to take shots. Big-time players take big-time shots.
That might have been a little bit of a force. No reset on the shot clock. They got to remember that. Powell off the mark. Well, that's why she was wide open. There's a reason why they doubled off of her.
Well, they doubled off, but it was also a zone that time. They're trying to take away the shooters of the in the corners by West Virginia.
This is the type of tempo, the type of pace that West Virginia wanted to play at. That's going to be a foul against Ashley Powell. So the missed jumper at one end and the foul at the other end. That is the fourth team foul against the Mountaineers. Connecticut with 17 fouls. We have a timeout. Cinderella still trying to fit on that glass slipper. Meanwhile, Strother says, hey, I got some Timberland boots for you. Back after this.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of Championship Week is presented by 7-Up. If you want 100% natural lemon and lime flavors, the only way to go is up.
Welcome back, everyone, to the Hartford Civic Center. It's UConn taking on West Virginia. The Huskies leading by three. Championship Week presented by 7-Up. The Big East Women's Championship presented by Aeropostal. 7:19 to go, and UConn trying to keep alive its streak of winning either a share of the regular season championship or the tournament championship, going all the way back to 93. And a couple of talented seniors putting an end, a few punctuation marks on their career. One of the men, Strother, with a key jump shot a few moments ago.
One of the things they're going to need to do is knock down. They're obviously looking for these three-point shots, but 2 for 15 for Connecticut, and in the win against West Virginia, they had 24 points off threes, 26 attempts in that game.
Well, that three-point shot off the mark, Nancy, and that's going to be a foul against Laquita Owens, the 5'9 sophomore from Charlotte, North Carolina. That's her third personal foul, the team's fifth foul. Montgomery lost it, and now the possession arrow in favor of West Virginia, so they can come to within one or tie it with a three. But the way that they have been shooting three-pointers, Nancy, I don't think I'd bet on it. just 1 of 15 from downtown.
They're 1 of 15. Connecticut is 2 of 16 from downtown. And I have to tell you, both teams have had open looks. They're just not knocking them down.
The ball fake and move by Davis-White, and she got a very auspicious bounce. And it's a one-point game. Davis-White with 7 points now on 3 of 14.
Yet again, West Virginia has gone away from the zone that has baffled pretty much all of the Big East teams they have played in this tournament.
10 seconds, Nancy, on the shot clock for the Huskies. Strother down on the block. A turnaround, and Ann Strother with another clutch jumper. There are some people that will criticize her on various message boards and otherwise, saying that she tends to disappear in big moments, but that's not the case tonight.
No, it's not, and you're seeing the zone by Connecticut. They want to make sure that they're keeping the ball out of the inside.
Three-pointer off the mark. They've just made 1 of 18 now from downtown.
How can you criticize Ann Strother after the career that this woman has had?
Exactly.
I mean, she's at the top of virtually all categories. Where is there room to criticize her? Because she's not as flamboyant as Taurasi or Bird or Cash?
Geno Auriemma said at the start of the year, Nancy, that we will go as far as Ann Strother wants to take us.
Well, she's a big-time player, always has been, reluctant to shoot sometimes because she's such a team player. Look at her. She can post you. This is just shows and speaks to her versatility. She recognized the matchup on the shorter Owens, squares her hips.
And the lead is swollen up to 6 again with 5:48 to go. Ann Strother, the senior, 6'3 from Castle Rock, Colorado.
And she's now surpassed Wendy Davis.
Look at her career numbers. Think about the fact that, hey, Pat Summitt on a recruiting trip to Tennessee had T-shirts made out with Strother's baby picture on it. All the Lady Vol players wore it on her visit, and the PA announcer at a packed Thompson Bowling Arena announced her name at the game. Wasn't enough. Andy Landers of Georgia planted a pink flamingo in her yard out in Colorado. That didn't work either. Whatever Geno did, it worked.
Yo, you're coming to Connecticut. You're going to like it. We're going to win, and you're going to play in front of, like, lots and lots of people.
Meanwhile, Cole with the layup for West Virginia brings them back to within 4. Under 5.5 minutes to go. The number 12 seed West Virginia in the championship game for the first time ever. It's the first time that a number 12 seed has made it this far in the conference tournament. They knocked off number 5, number 4, and number 1. Strother feeling the groove and shot it right over the top of Davis-White, earning a trip to the foul line.
These are good matchups right now for Connecticut because Owens is only 5'9", Davis-White is only 5'7", and stands about 6'2", but her release is so high. I would also like to make note she is now in second place behind Diana Taurasi in 3-pointers in her career.
As you mentioned before, Nancy, number 1 in minutes played, a lot of mileage on those Nikes of hers. And a few rings, too.
Oh, yeah, 2 championship rings for this senior class.
Strother giving Connecticut a 6-point lead. As we approach 5 minutes to go, is there one more push, one more thrust left with Cinderella, West Virginia? Trying to get the ball inside to Sanni. They take another 3, and the misery continues. Sanni missing the putback out of bounds, and it's West Virginia basketball.
They're getting some looks, especially off offensive rebounds. Sanni just forcing a little too hard on the putback.
Inside. Now out back out to Powell. Plenty of time on the shot clock. I'm not sure about Davis-White's decision to let one fly there. The lead at 6. 1.5 minutes to go.
Just think if they just could get a little offense out of Ashley Powell. I mean, it's tough playing 4 against 5 and not getting that contribution.
Strother, straight butter. And Strother has given Connecticut an 8-point lead, showing some steely resolve.
Going to the message boards.
Oh.
I want. Okay, you got to own up to get the kid her props. If you're going to rip her, give her her due.
She is showing out tonight. 7 on the shot clock. Powell still can't buy one. Sanni with the rebound. Pull up no good that time by Davis-White. And a foul underneath. It's going to go against the Mountaineers. And Strother, highly publicized and sometimes criticized, but tonight, on point. Strike and a pose. We'll be back after this.
Hello.
Trey Wingo here with you. You can't make this stuff up. Mid-Continent Conference Finals, ORU and Chicago State. Ken Tutt for ORU, born in Arizona, moved to Oklahoma, got a condo made of Stona, baby. He sinks the three. ORU going to the big dance. They win it 85-72. Courtney Lee from the Hilltoppers coming up next. Sun Belt Finals, WKU against South Alabama. Take that one, Mark Jones.
Hey, it's tough to follow up on Ken Tutt.
Hey, no,
I have no response for that.
No more Red Bull for Trey and Doris. You're cut off.
I caught the lyrics. I caught that whole vibe, you know. Born in Arizona.
Sing for us here the last 3:39.
8 minutes, 8-point lead. 3:39 to go, and Barbara Turner stepping up to the foul line for Connecticut. The second half has been all about Barb Turner, but Ann Strother. He's made several key baskets here in the last 5 minutes. And finally, the second three-pointer of the ballgame for Davis-White.
They are now 7 of 40, the backcourt, the perimeter, the three scorers for West Virginia.
And they come up with the steal. Powell had an opportunity to run out. Instead, she walks it up. I don't get that with about 3 minutes to go.
I don't either. You got to get this in tight. Score quick.
And Sanni fouled by Wilnett Crockett, stopping the clock, importantly, for West Virginia. And an opportunity now to put a couple on the board for Sanni.
Look at the position Sanni gets. She gives you a good target. She's feeling, reading defense, and she goes right to the heart of the player. That's where you draw the contact.
Just a 51% free throw shooter, though, on the season.
And she appreciates you bringing that up.
In the face of the statistics, makes the first. Uchenka gave her a nice breather in the first half and put up 10 in the period. And getting back to Sanni, you know, last year she attended Pete Newell's big man's camp and was voted the most likely to make a breakthrough, which she did recently.
Yeah, she was much improved. She has great hands and footwork, and she did a great job. She shut down Louisville's Jazz Covington. She did a great job against St. John's Chambers, held her to 8 points.
4-point game for the lowest seed ever to make it into the tournament final. Reverse layup, no good. And the Mountaineers with a chance to come to within two. Looking for that one last definitive final push. Owens with the layup, and it's a 2-point game. The Mountaineers still alive.
The man-to-man defense really, to me, has hurt them. They need to go back to their 2-3 zone or their matchup zone, because all Connecticut is doing is back-cutting them or finding the mismatches and getting, you know, Ann Strother the basketball.
Infuriated Geno Auriemma on the sidelines, and stark contrast, Carey with a different look, but boy, a nice hoop by Owens last time down the floor.
But look at this. She knew. Her eyes are right to the rim. This is not anything she's going to pass. She knows that they got to make hard defining moves quick.
He's the one that moved into the starting lineup after Meg Bolger blew her knee out, ending her season. 2:32 to go here at the Hartford Civic Center. UConn up by a pair. This is the Big East Championship game. I'm Mark Jones along with Nancy Lieberman, the Hall of Famer. And offensively, this game, anything but Hall of Fame-ish, but UConn up by a pair right now. The possession arrow in favor of Connecticut. Let's see what they do out of this timeout.
It's been an old-fashioned defensive battle.
Looks like they went back to their man defense, West Virginia.
They are back to their man. That's a better matchup, at least, with Paul on Strother.
Strother has been red hot in the last 5 minutes, going inside to Turner. Five on the shot clock. Turner had it knocked away, and the Mountaineers have a chance to tie or lead with a three ball.
Owens find her. Half the shots that she's taken this season have been from three. That's what she does. Cole and Davis-White love to put the ball on the floor and get to the rim.
Davis-White with 11 on the shot clock. Forced one up badly. Powell was there. No reset on the shot clock. Owens with the step through. Missed the layup. Sanni can't get it. Two chances, three chances to tie. The arrow in favor of the Huskies, you wonder, with so many glorious opportunities, will West Virginia ever get over the hump?
Unbelievable, the shots that they've had. You make layups and short shots with your eyes. Don't anticipate, so easy to say, don't anticipate the hit.
West Virginia has never won the Big East championship. They're the first 12 seed to make it to the title game. 1:20 to go. UConn clinging to a two-point lead. Strother out top. Had it knocked away. The Mountaineers with another opportunity. You don't get that many. And Mike Carey wants to talk it over with 1:09 to go. Still life left in Cinderella's last gasp effort.
You know, from a coaching standpoint, he has his offense in front of him. You like that because you want to be able to talk your kids through it. If you don't know what cut you're making or you forget the play, at least he's right there to talk you through that.
It has been an incredible journey, Nancy, for West Virginia. They knocked off number 5 Louisville, then number 4 St. John's, and number 1 Rutgers in back-to-back-to-back efforts. None of those coming easy. Here's what the scene looked like last night against Rutgers in the semifinal, with Meg Bolger praying to keep the lead. Cole with a nice drive to the bucket. And then the steal defensively. Key shots at the other end. That one a three-pointer, unlike tonight's story. And then a nice drive to the basket. West Virginia hanging on behind Cole, who had 18, and Davis-White, who had 21, with the upset of the number one seed Rutgers. And Cappy Pondexter left to ponder what might have been. But the crowd isn't on their side tonight. It's on UConn's side, and here's a look at the brackets to how we got to this point. Number 2 seed against the number 12 seed. The Mountaineers to inbound at midcourt.
If you're Powell, keep the ball in the middle of the court until you decide when you want to get into your play.
Sanni inside, point blank range, and they call a charge. That is the 4th foul against Sanni. That effort imploding immediately.
Oh yeah, great position by Barbara Turner. She rotated on the flight of the ball.
From this angle you couldn't tell, but the replay appeared to be true and vindicate the official's decision. Under a minute to go, 47 seconds.
It's a little pick-to-picker action. It's a down screen. Then you can come up for that foul line shot.
10 on the shot clock for Strother, spinning. Great feed, what a dime! Crockett with the layup. They played it man-to-man, Nancy, and not zone.
Gwinnett Crockett, big-time player, big games.
As Powell seemed a little bit confused, not getting the call for Mike Carey.
Look at this right here. Strother going one-on-one right there against Cole. When the rotation comes, if you're the post, you go to the front of the rim. Smart play by the senior Crockett.
And Strother, whether it be scoring or passing, has made every critical play here in the second half for the Huskies, giving them a 4-point lead. Statistically, it may not be pretty for Strother. 7 of 15, almost 50% from the field, 7 rebounds. The rest of her team, though, a different story. For Crockett, meanwhile, that was her first field goal of the game at a very timely juncture.
Well, she had a great game in the semifinals. 6 points, 7 rebounds, 3 steals, but she had 5 of those points in the final 2 minutes and 26 seconds of the semifinal game.
UConn has 9 team fouls. West Virginia with 8. And see what happens here as Cole will step to the free throw line. Down by 4.
And that's why Coach Auriemma was so upset with his kids, because why foul him out there? Stop the clock. Put a kid on the line who shot the ball so well the last couple of games.
And Cole, a 67% free throw shooter, Nancy, makes it.
67% during the regular season, 86% during the tournament. That's when you better knock down those shots.
Tipped up. That's going to be a foul underneath against Connecticut. And it looks like Davis-White will go to the free throw line, but she comes up limping, favoring that left leg. Davis-White, remember, was 14 of 20 from the foul line yesterday, and she gets an opportunity in the bonus here. That was the 10th foul for UConn.
And I have to tell you, the officials have done a magnificent job throughout the Big East tournament. I've been so impressed throughout the semis and this game, of course. They've let them play, but they've let them do what they have to do without interfering.
What do you make of the substitution with Bukar coming in for Sanni? Little defensive switch there. Don't know what to make of that with 29 and a half to go. A chance to bring them to within one. Just when it seems like West Virginia's out of it. Crockett comes back to relieve the pressure.
And you don't want to foul if you're West Virginia. See, that's why you gotta have, they gotta put the backboard in women's basketball. Why even pressure them? You gotta foul right away, stop the clock, play the percentage of the foul shooting game.
And Mel Thomas,
getting on the rules committee.
Make sure you get that fixed up for next year, would you, partner?
Yeah, that the possession arrow in the backcourt, gone.
Really takes away a part of the strategy of the game, doesn't it? As Thomas now will step to the foul line. On the season, 77%. Still a one-possession game, even if she makes this one. But it's not like West Virginia has made a lot of three-pointers tonight, Nancy. Just 2 of 18 from downtown.
No, but, you know, Mel Thomas is the right player. She's the most improved player in the Big East. And she's so clutch. She's got such a beautiful shot.
Auriemma calls a timeout, and 24 seconds to go. What does West Virginia do?
Well, they need to make sure that they have good spacing, and they have to take a three. I mean,
you go for the three right away?
No, I think you get a quick two. If it's early enough in the clock, you go inside to Sanni, try and get a quick two or maybe a natural three. If not, you've got to look for your outside shot, because it's that one possession game. You foul immediately no matter what happens.
24 seconds to go, and should UConn hang on to win? If they would, it would be remembered perhaps as one of the real indelible marks made by Ann Strother during her great tenure at UConn.
And look at her right here. This is when she started that little run of hers. She posted up. She was ready on the catch. And then this coming off the down screen. Then you talked about her dropping dimes and finding Crockett underneath the basket.
Well, it's interesting. You look at the score of 47 to 44. And Mike Carey said that if this game is in the 50s, we have an extremely good chance. If it's in the 60s, then our chances aren't as good. Well, it's in the 40s, Nancy, and they're right there still. So I don't think he could have asked for much better.
Well, he said from day one, if we could just hang around, if we're just around, anything can happen. A very smart play by Geno. All he's trying to do is get West Virginia to use clock.
Powell up court for the Mountaineers. Powell takes it all the way, and that's going to be a charge. Easy call. Terrible, egregious decision by Powell.
You live with your freshman, you die with your freshman. Right here, Powell, all you have to do is take the pull up. Why go to the post? She was waiting 3 steps. I mean, you couldn't have IM'd her or texted her. She was there waiting on you.
As you said, she is a freshman. They got a foul, and they do on the inbound pass. And the lead is three. Both teams now in the penalty with 10 team fouls each. And Strother will go to the free throw line. But that last turnover, the offensive foul by Ashley Powell, took away an opportunity to even get a shot at the bucket if you're West Virginia.
Okay, but now she's got to have amnesia. Okay, those are the things as a point guard you have to have. She cannot remember what just happened because they're going to get the ball with 17.2 seconds to go regardless of what Strother does. And she's got to make something happen with impact.
Owens just fouled out of the ball game for the Mountaineers.
And that's one of your shooters, your three-point shooters.
Owens leaves the game with 5 points on 2 of 12 from the field. Strother missing, so it stays a one-possession game. How much is left for the 12 seed? Strother trying to seal it shut for UConn. Bukar, and they throw it away. In two consecutive trips down the floor, the Mountaineers don't even get a shot at the basket.
And that's heartbreaking for a team that has come so far with so little player participation. They were only about seven deep. They have played their hearts out.
Seven deep. They backed into the conference tournament. They lost their last eight games in a row after losing arguably their best player, Meg Bulger, who will undergo surgery on her knee tomorrow. Mike Carey, their head coach, has done a wonderful job in reinventing who they are and what they are to get them this far, and knocking off three higher seeds. They came in the 12th seed out of 12 teams in this tournament. They knocked off number 5, Louisville, number 4, St. John's, number 1, Rutgers, but it appears as if the clock is about to strike 12 on Cinderella right here. Bukar missing, and that'll do it. It's cooked, glazed, sliced. UConn, the Big East champs. They've won either the conference tournament or the regular season title dating back to 1993. Final thoughts, Nancy.
I thought it was a wonderful defensive battle. Certainly, we talked about what West Virginia did. Kudos to Geno Auriemma and his staff for their 13th tournament title.
Where will they be on Selection Monday? We'll find out next Monday at 7:30 p.m. Eastern on ESPN. The final score, Strother leading the way for the Huskies, the 6-point victory. Right now, we're going to go back to the studio for an update. The final from here, 50-44. Back to you guys.
Mark, thanks very much. Don't forget, just moments away, Mario Joyner in South Alabama in the Sun Belt's Conference Championship taking on the Hilltoppers of Western Kentucky. Welcome back to our studios here. Trey Wingo here with Doris Burke. And Doris, congratulations to UConn. Congratulations to Ann Strother in a big moment. They found their big-time scorer in Strother. This is what UConn has been looking for all season long, Doris.
Yeah, Mark Jones and Nancy Lieberman addressed the criticism this young woman has taken. Well, it's been for not being there in big moments. Traditionally, in her first and second season, she was outstanding in big spots. But this last couple of years, this team has struggled offensively. She's the most capable player, and she showed it through the second 20 minutes of this basketball game. When things were coming undone for her basketball team, she made every big play at every big moment. When the double came, she's smart enough to kick it off. But those are the kinds of plays you hope that they make. Now, does this performance, and every committee member in the country watched this basketball game, was this good enough to get the Connecticut Huskies a number one seed? Their RPI, Trey, is 4, so you think that's got a shot at it. But how about Ohio State on a 19-game win streak? Perhaps they got a chance.
Ohio State would absolutely have the argument against UConn being a number one seed. Well, let's go to Geno Auriemma. What does he think about his number one seed? He's standing by right now with Nancy. Nancy, take it away.
Congratulations, Ann Strother and Geno Auriemma. Geno, for the 13th time, you go home with the Big East Championship tournament. What did you feel about this victory? It was hard fought.
I think this was harder than all the other 12 put together. you know, but I thought our guys really battled through a lot of stuff tonight. And, you know, we didn't shoot the ball well. We played against a really good team that played their hearts out. And, you know, Ann came up big the last 10 minutes. And, you know, that was the difference. You know, she just played like, you know, the All-American that she is.
And coach is talking about how you played, especially during that stretch in the second half. You end up with 20 points and 7 rebounds. Did you feel like it was your time to take over?
Well, I think there was a time where nothing was really going. Our offense was kind of stagnant. I think we needed to get something going if we were gonna win this. So that was the time.
Were you surprised at how they decided to go man-to-man against you and stay and get out of their zone?
Yeah, a little bit. I mean, the first time we played them in Gamble, they played zone the whole game almost, so it was a little bit of a switch for them.
Well, congratulations on the championship.
Thank you.
Well done.
All right, congratulations to UConn. Anthony Winchester in Western Kentucky looking to do what UConn did. Sun Belt Championship next on ESPN2, taking on South Alabama. Enjoy.